All right, let's test this bad boy out here in the fields. So basically, as you can see, I was in a motorcycle accident. Very stupid. I think I told you the story already. If I haven't, just tell me. And I'm walking to Ramallosa. It's near where I live, ish. Maybe 1 or 2 kilometers away, I don't know. And it's where I took the, well, I called the tow car to pick the motorcycle up, and they took it to this workshop, which is called Moto 4, right? Motorcycle 4, or something, Moto 4, if you translate. And by the way, I like this hotel, Miramar. Quite good, I recommend it. And yeah, so basically my insurance company said they have the right to, you know, 25% of the repair bill, right? And I told them okay, but I don't know how, what the extent of the damages are, because the motorcycle didn't suffer many damages. Actually, it who suffered the damage was me. Basically, it just got a few scratches and some bent little add-overs, you know, little accessories. Nothing, like the handlebars are fine, it turns over just fine, just starts fine, you know. Now, the cap of the coolant was removed. Some asshole took it, and that's it. So I said, okay, just replace the coolant. And if the only other thing I can think of, if any other damage, that might be an issue, is the front wheel. Is it bent or not? I don't know. I don't think so. It does have a scratch, where it basically hit against the curb of the sidewalk. But that's it, you know? And they didn't come back to me. They didn't want to cooperate with the insurance guy. Want to see the bike to get a budget and all that stuff. So, one second, I'll put my sunglasses on. So I was like, fuck you guys. And they were like, listen, they called me and said, yo, listen, your bike is taking up space in the shop. We need to move it and we're gonna charge you money every day. Oh, really? Is that so? Don't you worry, baby. I'm gonna go pick it up. I can't. I don't have anyone to help me remove the bike. I think see if I can negotiate with them so they can just leave it on the street. And then whenever I recover or I find someone willing to to bring it where I live, then that'll be it. But I just want to pay them and tell them to fuck off and leave a very bad review. I'm actually one of the top 1 or 2% reviewers on Google. People really like my reviews. And I write them, like, not with a huge effort, but I do put a little bit of effort, you know, at least like 2 or 3 lines saying, you know, stating my experience. If it's good, I'm fair, you know, I'm a good judge, I think. If I like it, I like it. If I don't, I don't. And I'm not that strict, usually. But when people do something like this, especially when I just underwent surgery, and I'm in one of the lowest points of my life, even though I'm still happy and I'm still strong or whatever, it just shows me how little people care. I just want to see them face to face because I've never seen them face to face. I think that's also a big factor. I think as soon as they see me, you know, with this brace and all that, maybe they're going to change their tune, be more understanding, less cunty. But hey, I don't know. You know, I'm really disappointed in them. Only, you know, first try. It's just, you know, I saw that they had bad reviews on Google, but I said I gotta give them a fair chance, you know. And yeah, disappointed, but whatever. So as I'm going now, that's finished, you know, that's that. I'll give you another example, you know, to be another slight issue, but not really. It's like a completely different reaction to a very similar problem. I contacted this guy a couple weeks ago because I need new tires for my van. The front tires are worn, and it's raining a lot here in Galicia. And, oh, I forgot my umbrella. It looks like it's not gonna rain. We'll see. And if not, I'll buy another one. I contacted him, you know, I didn't know, I wasn't sure which tires to get, the sizing, the fitting, all that stuff, right? And I decided to go for Yokohama's, Japanese brand, because Michelin was way too expensive, and the reviews were not that good. Usually Michelin tires are pretty good, to be fair. A motorcycle, bicycle tires, and even car tires are usually very good. But it's a van, you know, it's a specific size and all that stuff. And I thought they were way too expensive for what they were. And they were not even all weather. They were like more summer tires. And I need, at the very least, all weather. Four seasons or, you know, winter tires even, you know. Because it's super slippery. It's always wet here. It's been raining nonstop for 2 months. So, yeah. A lot of moss and shit and, like, leaves on the road, and you need good tires because the ones I've got, they keep sliding. So he got them, and I said, yo, you know, I cannot drive the van, obviously. I've got surgery and all that stuff. Can I just stop by and pay for it, and then when I can finally drive it or get someone to drive the van there, you can install it. He said, dude, you don't have to pay them until you bring the van. You know, as long as it takes, I'll keep the tires here, no problem. Recover, you know, get well soon. That's your priority and all that stuff. What a different experience, man. And that's just, to me, basic human decency. He's such a nice guy and I love him, you know. And I went anyway. I paid for the tires, I insisted, you know. I got the invoice so I can just, or the bill, and I can just, you know, come back with it any day and get the tires installed. Such a cool guy, you know, no issues, you know. But these assholes don't. And previously, like, for example, when I got run over by a car this summer. Yeah, this year has not been my year with motorcycles. They kept the broken motorcycle for like 2 months or 3 months, and they never told me anything that I occupied space or they're gonna charge me or anything like that. No problems until, you know, I think it's still there. I still have to go. I don't know. I have too many open fronts. And this year has been my year. It's kind of weird, you know. Because I finally got money and the bicycles and motorcycles of my dreams. But then I just had to work all summer. I couldn't enjoy them. And now that I'm back to work as usual, you know, I get into this accident. Which is kind of nice in the sense that I'm getting my holidays in the end. Just not the way I wanted them. I missed my flight to California. I don't know. It's been crazy. It's been very, very chaotic. And good luck and bad luck all mixed together, you know? I did go jet skiing and kart racing and see adventure parks and shit, but then the weather was horrible at the adventure park, so we couldn't do shit. I don't know. It's a mixed bag, you know? A little bit of everything. But I can't really complain, honestly. I'm much better than I used to be many years ago. I had severe depression, suicidal thoughts on the daily, and I'm happy, you know. And even though, sure, like breaking my wrist in several spots and getting two iron pieces stuck there with a screw might sound horrible, and it is painful, it is exhausting and incredibly painful, I'm not gonna lie. Still, as long as I got money and I can work and I can walk, I'm good, you know? The rest will solve itself out. And well, here you can see a little bit of where I am. People running with their dogs, you know? The canine unit. And I couldn't care, you know, the looks people give me. It's like, dude, have you ever, you know, it's a vlog, just let me be. And look at this, it's beautiful. Beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. I could also take in that route. It's twistier, but it's prettier. But I prefer on the bike, you know. It's fine. And yeah, guys, so lesson of the day, just to finish, you know, organizing my thoughts. If you can run, well, if you can ride a motorcycle, ride a motorcycle. If you can't ride a motorcycle, drive a car. If you can't drive a car, ride a bicycle. you can't drive a bicycle, ride a bicycle, run. If you can't run, walk. If you can't walk, limp. If you can't limp, crawl. If you can't crawl, drag yourself across the ground. Okay, do anything, or just be pushed with a wheelchair, okay? Just keep moving, never stop, never quit, keep going, you know? Fuck it. If life gets hard, you have to be tougher, you know? You have to be harder than life. Who's gonna carry the boats? Who's gonna carry the boats? All right, guys, I'll leave you to it. Have a good one.